Okay, okay, what's the question?
It's on the last one, I love the radius, square and the radius, we got it.
Okay, so what was the question, let's start at the beginning, what was the question?
It was the, right, the equation, the circle, the diameter.
Okay, what were the two points?
Five, -3, 1, 5.
1, 5?
Yeah.
Okay, so you found the midpoint?
Yeah, it was only the radius, I got circles.
Yep, so I gotta start from the beginning, so midpoint average was 3, 1. So x minus 3 squared plus y minus 1 squared?
Yeah.
Now, to find the radius, did you do this? Or?
I did the diameter and then divided by 2.
Okay, so if we do that, he, I'm doing it his way, he found the diameter, which would be, 5 minus 1 is 4, 16. -3 minus 5. -3 minus 5 would be -8, wouldn't it?
Oh, I think.
And squared is 64?
I had it backwards on my thing, yeah.
Well, 5 minus -3 would still be.
Oh, yeah, I switched up the y coordinates.
Oh. So the diameter is root 80, which is 4 root 5. So the radius would be 2 root 5. So I have to square that to put it here. So that would be 4 times 5, that would be 20.
Yeah, I switched up the y coordinates.
Okay, who else has a question? Anything I handed back, we'll start with that and then we'll go to the review sheet. Anything I handed back that is, I'm not sure, Ally?
Do you think number 1 is 5?
Can you tell me what the problem is?
It's finding the dimensions of an orbit.
Oh, okay, yeah. So tell me about, I know they tell me this is x, and then what else do I know? I know something else.
The bottom's x.
Yeah, it's a square, I know that, what else?
Oh, no, no.
200, so the area is 200. So I know that this thing is made up of a square whose area is x squared, and a semicircle whose area is 1/2 pi r squared, because it's a semicircle, so it's 1/2 of pi r squared. And that has to equal 200. Now, tell me about, this is the radius. Tell me what that radius would be.
Half of x.
Half of x. Right? So the radius is half x. So instead of having an r in my equation, I'm gonna go ahead and replace it with half x. Okay, so I'm gonna clean this up right here, so that's gonna be 1/2 pi times 1/4 x squared, which makes a grand total of 1/8 pi x squared. Now that's a really messy looking equation, but it's actually a lot easier than it looks, because I can factor out an x squared. And that will leave me with 1 plus 1/8 pi. You still with me? Now, remember I'm solving for x. So I'm gonna go ahead and divide by that parentheses. Now, I know that's really ugly, but remember, we got a calculator. So I'm gonna type this in on my calculator, and then I'm gonna take the square root of it, right? And that will be my answer. Now, those of you that are real good with parentheses and all that, you can go ahead and square root this whole thing. I mean, type that in. I'm gonna go ahead and just type in the fraction. So 200 divided by parentheses. one plus one divided by eight pi, and I'm gonna use my pi button, which is over here, right? Gone are the days of 3.14, that's like sixth grade, we're using our pi button. Equals. And now I need to take the square root of that number. So on my calculator, because it's old, I don't have the ability to go up and like click and cut and paste. The newer calculators do. I have to do square root and then second answer. And that way it pulls that number down for me and I don't have to retype it. And I get 11.98. So I'm not sure, was the question 5x? 11.98 inches. I don't know what that is. Whatever you do, it wasn't a problem. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
All right. Anything else?
Aiden?
Is this from homework?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead and read me the question.
Solve for
an integral
where
s equals
pi to r squared plus 2 pi r.
Yeah, I have the equation right.
Yes.
And what am I solving for?
H.
H. All right, I'm solving for H. What I would do is subtract this one. So s minus 2 pi r squared. Equals 2 pi r h. And then I would divide by 2 pi r. So this would be my answer. Now, you could also split that up if you wanted to. S over 2 pi r minus r. That would be the same thing. So put s over this and put this over this. Bunch of that cancels. So that would be another way, but I would just leave it like that, personally, but this is the same thing. We're all good? All right, who's looked at the review sheet? Let's get a couple in from the review sheet before I let you head to lunch.
First problem,
number one.
I didn't get an answer.
So here we go. This is our box problem. I know we just did it, but let's do it again to make sure everybody's got it under control. This time the paper is 22 by 14. So my volume equation will be what? What is my volume going to be?
22
minus 2x. 14 minus 2x. And x. And I need what to be at least 210. So at least 210 technically would be greater than or equal to 210. Now, I'm going to go ahead and graph this on my calculator, but I'm paying attention to that domain that he's talking about, because he said I didn't get any answers between 0 and 7. And isn't that where my answers would have to come from?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to go ahead, let's type that in. I'm going to type in 'cause that's just what I'm comfortable doing. You do whatever you're comfortable doing. Somebody earlier said, well, what if I don't do it your way? I don't care. That's perfect. That's great. Do it your way. As long as you're not cheating, it's all good. Ooh, man, I got two. right again.
Yeah.
Because mine goes off the screen with my window, but I know these are the 2 points that I want. Did everybody else get a couple of points of intersection? Which should be the case no matter what, no matter which way you get it. 0.839. How do those look like what somebody else got? Does anyone match that? Okay. And then we got to answer the question that's asked, which is, we want to a volume of at least 210. So this is where they equal 210. And isn't this where they'd be more than 210? So your answer would be 0.839 to 5.261. All right, one more. Anywhere on the sheet. We found
four.
This is a projectile thrown from the top of the building. Okay, so first thing, we gotta make sure that we have our formula down. And this time, the initial velocity 100, and the building is 24 feet tall. Does this make sense to everybody? And avoid confusion, this is the height. This is not two variables, this is function notation. Like f of x is the same as y, this is the height.
So if they give you the t, would you plug in the t?
Yep. You would find like S of 4 by plugging in 4. Yep. So that would be a question like, how high is the ball after 10 seconds? Right? And you just plug in 10. Now this says, when will the height be 50? So what do I need to do? Put 50 here? Built into the equation. Yep, that's already built in. So we want the height to be 50. All right, so this can be done with the quadratic formula. Since we've already done some graphing, let's practice that. But we'll do that when we get that formula. We'll solve this with the quadratic formula, okay? So go to lunch. And I want you to leave the cafeteria, or excuse me, the dining hall, at 12:20, which means you should be back up here by about 12:20. But you gotta be out of the cafeteria at 12:20, okay? Go. Go.